Well, the vision of Newbreak Church is to be in communities, loving communities, and shaking communities for Jesus. And so we really want to have impact. That's why we exist. If a church doesn't do anything for its community, it's not really fulfilling her vision just in general as a church. And as a result of that, Newbreak is made up of mostly unchurched people, and quite frankly, for people who don't really necessarily like church. That's actually a part of how we go about it, producing environments that are for people who wouldn't want a normal church. They want something a little bit more, let's say, relevant and creative. So that's kind of how we roll. We've been in the same church plant for 27 years, and it was under 200 for 14 years, which is very helpful to church planners because they think, you know, they only hear the phenom stories. So 14 years, but then we broke through the 200 barrier, and then it just kept growing and growing and growing. We were in many different locations over the course of time, but ultimately we landed in a strip mall. And AGFS actually helped us finance that original purchase of that mall, which was majorly strategic in Newbreak's history. When we were able to get into that mall, it was a strategic endeavor that had impact for years to come. Then we planted our first multi-site, and then we adopted another one, and then now we have like six campuses all over San Diego County. And there's about 3,000 people in a worship experience in Newbreak on a weekend. We baptize a lot of people every year, but this past couple of weeks ago, really now, we baptized the largest amount of people we ever baptized in one setting, and it was 212 people we baptized, most of them adults, but we had a big barbecue and blues bands and just kind of had a great time down at the beach area. Mission Bay is where we are, and it was just off the hook. I mean, it was crazy. We were all crying. I mean, and it takes a long time to baptize 212 people. And there were probably 10 groups baptizing. So you can do the math. I mean, that's an amazing problem. So it's crazy. There's a difference between normal banks or financial institutions and AGFS. AGFS has the feel to us like you really want to partner with us in it. Even from a spiritual perspective, I mean, the business part has to be sound, but there's a spiritual partnering. So it's kind of like you're doing the financing with ministry people that are helping you to fund the vision that God has on our lives in Newbreak, and any pastor for that matter in the assembly. So it's a sort of fundamentally different relationship. It's not, let's say, adversarial, it's more partnering. Well, for a pastor, perhaps of a church plant or in a regular church, but needing financing at strategic moments, they should really just contact AGFS, and then there will be a person basically assigned to them to help navigate the waters. And even though it's complex to a pastor, AGFS, they know how to do it in a way that's friendly, if I could put it, and make it sort of simple for us and really walk us hand by hand almost through the process, so that at the end of the game you're financed for the vision that's burdening your heart. And then it's this partnership where pastors and AGFS collaborate together to knock it out, right, and to reach their communities for Christ, because that's what it's all about. At the end of the day, that's what is all of this is about. Because there's nothing that'll freak pastors out more than, oh my goodness, what if I miss a payment? That kind of stuff, it weighs on us. So AGFS, the vibe of it is just a little bit different. It's not like it is a very sound financial institution, but it functions more like a true partner. Plus, we're all AG, so we're all helping each other. Just like I do in a multi-site world, AGFS does this from a financial perspective. We're all in the same deal. We're all building the kingdom of God, and we're collaborating together to do it. And we personally love that feature of AGFS in particular.